Another item, we were recognized back in September by the Great Southwest Council of the Boy Scouts. We had sponsored their Railroad Merit Badge this year, and part of that will be in 2020, trying to motivate some troops to come up and work during work sessions. I think we have a great opportunity for them, so we're working with the council down in Albuquerque to do that, and certainly other parts of the country as well, as far as that goes. And then last but not least, you mentioned OY. We had 37 Friends members that helped on that restoration project, and that's basically was the wood part of it, because I know Stothy has to take on the shop has to take on the mechanical end of it, but there were 37 individuals that helped
That's great.
Tear out rotten wood and put new and a lot of other things, rough.
Which
and,
there was a lot of rotten wood.
Right. So anyway, with that, that is pretty much my report. And we thank you for...
How are you doing on membership, Tim?
Our membership?
Yeah.
We're pretty much status quo. I mean, one of the big items as an organization is we are trying to increase that. We've talked to Launch and another organization that maybe can help us with some generational marketing because we realized...
Traditional?
Multi-generational, because we realize the task at hand is to try and bring in younger folks. I mean, and we're targeting really three generations, baby boomers, Gen Xers, and millennials. And to pass the torch, we're going to have to, again, get some younger blood in here. And you have to package it a different way. Just as Mark talked about traditional versus digital, you know, there's some things we have to look at. We've got some ideas just how we can do that, but we need to build the membership. But at least we're staying status quo financially. We're probably had the best year ever in the 15 years I've been here, because as a maturing organization, which is over 30 years old, we've had a lot of members that will, you know, pass on, and so we see some estate gifts, some that are expected and some that are not. So, you know, when I open up envelopes that sometimes have six-figure checks, it's like, oh, we weren't expecting that. Yeah. But so from a financial standpoint, we are very, very well off. It's just now trying to continue to build our membership.
Good. What are you, what's the level right now?
We're in the 2,200 range.
Okay.
So we've been kind of staying at that plateau.
And if I remember past meetings accurately, you were concerned about the level of participation in the work sessions, which are terribly critical.
Correct.
To the railroad.
Correct. And that was discussed at our board meeting as well, because it's trended down over the last 5 years. And it's, you know, again, a number of different factors, health, people dying, And sometimes people that have been engaged for 20, 25 years and saying, you know something, this has been great, I've had fun, but before I leave this earth, I want to do some other things.
Yeah.
I want to travel, and you can't blame them.
Right.
So that's why we do have to. But I will mention this, that OY special sessions we had some first-time attendees that came and helped on that project. So we're always looking for a lot of the first-timers, and we want to get them engaged. So with that, good question. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you and your members.
Well, we appreciate it.
So important. So wonderful.
Enjoy it.
And I just like to comment that the partnership that represented by the work on OY shows the railroad and the Friends working hand in hand to accomplish our objective, and it's just absolutely awesome.
Yeah, and OY, and I would say the cab and the pilot on 168, where again, those guys, you know, led by Craig McMullen, they love woodwork. And, you know, like I said, with the cab, one previous commission meeting, he hated to see black paint have to be put on it.
Yes.
Because it was so beautiful, you know. But we have some great woodworkers and a lot of skill sets that, you know, as we talked about yesterday, and I'll finish, I don't want to get too long here, but
you're fine.
One of the projects we talked about among many was the car inspector's house up at Cumbres. And we have such a skill set, led by Bob Connery, that we were able to tear that building down, demoed it, and now they're going to rebuild it. And that is quite a feat.
Yeah. In a short time.
In a short time. And for some of you don't know, that there was some stabilization issues with the ground. But then the other thing that happened, which maybe some of you don't know, was back in, I believe, John said the 90s, that the structure kind of got kittywampus because there was a tornado that went over Cumbres Pass. And it took the building and kind of turned it sideways a little bit, just minor. But anyway, I wanted to comment because that's a good story.
It is.
All right, with that, I'll shut up and I'll...
Well, and the other thing that's totally fantastic is the work that was done on the lava pump house.
Oh, it is.
A great artifact that we have to be proud of. And it was totally re-roofed and has been... And the beautiful masonry work has been brought up to speed, too. It's a great project.
Yeah, and the vent that's been totally redone. There was a vent that was used to let the heat escape when it had a boiler in it, but it had become target practice for hunters, and they really redone that, too. So
yeah,
it looks fantastic. So anyway.
It does.
Anyway, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I'd like to make one more comment. You know, there's a big deal going on now about the historic car fleet and all that historic train that we're putting together. But none of that would be possible if it were not for the fact that some visionaries 40 years ago or so got involved in creating a volunteer group that in directly saved some of the assets. It was, in fact, members of the Friends who purchased some of the assets that have now been restored and are being restored to make all of this possible.
That's,
so,
well, that's right, and you've got to thank Mr. Yeah. Locke, who had the foresight 31 years ago to make
well,
this happen.
It is in part intended as thanks for him, but it's also intended as thanks to the Friends organization for all that sort of stuff. You know, I probably don't say thank you as often as I should to people, but what we do now would not be possible if other visionaries hadn't started doing it before. It's hard to preserve the stuff that's already gone. And of course, that's a place where the Friends have played a critical role.
Well, John, thank you. Appreciate that very much. Thank you.
Thanks, Tim.
You bet.
That's great.